Appreciate you coming with me, man.
No doubt. Yo, Angelo. Man, this chick Sharice came by the crib the other day.
Now, you didn't let her in, did you?
No, I didn't do that.
Okay, cool, man, because that chick is crazy, bro. She set my last car on fire.
Word, man. You must have put it on her.
Nah, man, I didn't even hit. That's the crazy part. We just kissed a few times. Nothing major. I ain't had no feelings for her.
Good. I'm glad you didn't have any feelings for her.
Why you say that?
Man, when she came to the crib, she blew the hell out this Tuesday and let me hit it from the back.
Wow, for real, man?
Yeah.
Nah, I mean, for real, man. Like, for real, man? Like, if I would have had feelings for her, would you have told me you hit?
Well.
Nah, you wouldn't have told me. Hey, man, get on my car, bro. You dirty for that.
But, Angelo.
Peace out, man. I can't believe this dude would do that, man. We supposed to be friends, but he ever sleeping with chicks in my house? You got money? I need to go somewhere and just get my hair right real quick. Do something adventurous. Ah, good old strip club. That'll make any man happy. What's going on, everybody? It's Earn, Mr. Showtime, aka Justin Bieber, aka voice to make some moist. Back at y'all another video with another episode of the NBA 2K13 The Life series, featuring Angelo Wallace, and we're up in game 4 against the Denver Nuggets. But we're trying to get this win in game 3 and go back to Sacramento and try to get a win there so we will not have to come back to Denver again. All right, so let's go ahead and hop into the shoes. Well, actually, Angelo Wallace isn't wearing these shoes. Now, Angelo Wallace has on his signature shoe. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually show you some hybrids. Now, what hybrids are, there are shoes that are mixed all into one shoe. Now, these shoes right here are the Jordan 6 rings. Now, what 6 rings are? 6 rings is every shoe that Jordan wore when he won a championship, all, you know, consolidated into one. So that means it had the 6s, the 7s, the 8s, the 11s, the 12s, and the 13s. And actually, the 14s are incorporated in this shoe. So if you did not know, in Jordan's last game as a Chicago Bull, he wore the Jordan 14s. It was actually a prototype that they had shipped over to him, you know, to check out the shoe, see if he had liked the design and whatnot. But to their surprise, he actually, you know, wore those shoes in the same game as the last shot. So if you didn't know that, then that's a little bit of education for you right there about Jordan sneakers. I mean, I'm a sneakerhead. Well, not a sneakerhead, but I'm a Jordan sneakerhead. And I gotta know things like that. So I got the rock right here. Time is coming down. Outlaw hit the 3 right there. I told y'all, anytime y'all get this guy the ball, man, it's like he's pretty much going to make the shot. So close game right here, down by 2. Launching the ball back to me. Triple up. Triple down as I'm getting that 3-point bucket to go in. And for some reason, since we started these playoffs, man, I probably got the wettest shot out here. Triple up. Triple down. I'm telling y'all, ever since the playoffs have started, my 3-point shot has been pretty much automatic for me. It's been automatic. I don't know what's going on, but hey, I'm just hitting all type of threes out here. So for some reason, they keep playing Andre Miller at the two guard spot. I don't know why, but oh, Nuggets, and I'm getting a steal right here coming down the court. You know what it is, showtime. Showtime dunk right there on the windmill, coming down off the hot pocket. Steal, gotta get those steals out here so you can get out on them breaks and get them thirsty buckets. You feel me? So I'm coming up right here, crossing, going to the rack. And Andre Iguodala is too late getting over there to try to block my shot. No, you gotta jump at me early. Thomas Robinson going down low, and I'm picking up me another assist. This guy's been coming up big for us in these playoffs. I'm telling y'all, he's just doing his thing out here. So I'll pass it down to Thomas Robinson again right there. Thomas Robinson getting another slam jam dunk. You know, T-Rob, he's just that guy. Triple up, triple down, getting that three-point bucket to go in right there. Angelo Wallace is turned up, beating his chest and everything. Now off the missed shot right here, I'm getting the rock. I'm going to pass it up to my man Thornton, and he hit the three, and he's sweating. Woo! Hit the three, and he's sweating. Woo! We out here sweating. Perspiring, whatever you want to say. Perspiring, that's so funny. I just thought of that. Triple up, triple down right there. I'm telling y'all, man. Angelo Wallace, the threes is raining in. I'm going to have to say Rainmaker next time I hit a three. Shout out to K-Spade. But someone asked me about Jrue Fredette in one of my last videos, and I'm telling you, he only plays like 5 minutes a game, man. You know, that's like his only highlight, and that would probably be his only highlight, you know, in these playoffs, no matter how far we go. I'm telling you, because he doesn't play, and for some reason, he doesn't like to shoot. All right, so check me out right here, going behind the back, spinning, throwing up this shot right here on little man Ty Lawson, picking up me another bucket. Tie game right here, 104-104, and we're just like giving the ball back to each other. I'm like, yo, cut to the basket. He cuts to the basket. Simons right there, and we get the lead. So, tie game once again, it's showtime. Oh, slam jam showtime dunk right there. Look at the hoop. Look at the hoop. He might have been Baby Shaq on that play because he just had the hoop rocking all types of ways after that dunk right there on JaVale McGee. I'm trying to penetrate right here. Giving up to my man Cousins. He misses it, but McGee gets the board. And they're passing the rock up. Iguodala right there. Dunking the ball. Let's go ahead. You know, skip that right there. So we're down 3 points right here, and I'm bringing it up. I'm seeing my man down low, Thomas Robinson with the Gatorade cup, and we get the layup right there. All right, so I'm going to pass right down here to DeMarcus Cousins. DeMarcus Cousins getting the layup right there, 115-114. Now we're keep flip-flopping, going back and forth. My man Evans cutting right there open and getting the layup, so now, like I said, we're going back and forth at this point. 117-116 right here. So I lost him bringing the rock up. I'm D'ing his ass up and high pockets. Coming down here, I'm seeing my man cutting Evans, jamming it down right there, getting the dunk. So now we're up by 3 points at this moment. They missed the shot right here. And I'm like, yes, we're going to win. And Thornton, like, why didn't you just take that easy shot? I mean, seriously, now we're just going to go to the line. I have to shoot free throws. That didn't make any sense to me. I was kind of mad about that. But luckily, we get out of here with the win. Thank you guys for watching. And I want y'all to make sure y'all check out Game 5 that will be on Full House Wednesday. All right? Showtime.
Double figures and assists for you with 13. And fact, you were really moving the ball well from start to finish. How much of a factor do you think that had in the win?
Oh, it helped, no question. I thought the team played pretty well overall, though. My passing was just one part of that. It always feels good to contribute to a win in any way, to tell you the truth. I like to try to do it with my passing as much as I can, but if we're winning games, I'll do it with scoring, playing D, whatever, man.